Hey, boys and girls, Jimmy Joe back.
Cold Revolution.
And we're here for the grand finals at 3:15 in the morning, Saturday. I'm coughing. All right.
37 people came in. Steven came all the way from New Hampshire. Isn't going to Maryland. We've got Jimmy Joe coming from Hoboken.
Oh, Kiro decided to go with Captain Falcon.
Ah. Wait. Yeah, you're right. I had no idea what was going on.
Crazy DI there.
This is the back.
Kiro gets another shot at Sensei here. We got to play in Winners Finals.
Did Kiro win one of those?
He did. He won against Sensei's Fox, Pika Fox.
Mm. Sensei doesn't want to repeat that.
Falcon Tech. Pulling into the Falcon Smash.
Wonder in a Falcon Ditto between Kiro and his brother, who would prevail? Kiro looks like he has a solid Falcon.
Sensei, you know, the older brother always wins, bro.
Going for the taunt cancel. Yeah.
That's the ledge guard with a forward smash after a nice down air to keep him off the ledge.
Pivots.
Sounds like trying to maybe bait with an up smash.
Misses that one.
Falcon is probably capitalizing on that grab.
Just gets a forward smash.
Pico survived.
Ooh, could be a fight.
Almost gets a spike off, but can't quite reach. And Pika recovers to the top ledge, only to be up aired out of the stage. It's pretty tight right now.
As Genie starts to vacuum.
Beginning to clean this venue up as this is the last match.
Everyone else
is tripled
out.
Oh, a beautiful chase with that neutral air. Great neutral air. Could be a standard Falcon combo.
Ooh. Interrupted.
Oh, catch
each other's combos very nice.
Wow. Fortuitous for Kiro here.
Even match.
Good DI there from Sensei to wind up behind him.
Did he DI into a reverse hitbox?
I guess he did from the first one.
I'll take it.
The first hit, he DI'd
into the body.
In the reverse hitbox, yeah. This Captain Falcon is taking him forward. Nice forward smash read on the roll. He drops to the platform, back right in the back here.
Ooh, that ledge cancel.
Yes. No! Ground and spike, back throw.
Sweet spot. Possible up in there. Where Pika's gonna go. Back air. Sensei takes the first.
This game's winner is.
Hero's gonna get to choose a counter pick. So far, they've only played Magic on Dreamland.
Hint, hint.
Hint, hint, yeah. They're gonna stay.
Sensei's
gonna switch up to Fox. And Kiro's gonna go Pika.
This
they played
the match.
This match. Yeah, this is the one. Took a game off of him in Winners Finals.
And it's the same amount still. Best of five.
Sensei really good with this laser game. But last time, this wasn't enough. He was gimped by this Pika. Kiro managed to DI behind Fox during that drill.
So there's a YouTube comment that exists that counted Sensei's lasers in a match. Somewhere over 100, 127, I think.
Nice.
Very useful information.
That's a very good with Fox. Able to get that double jab to up smash combo. And as you're watching this video, you know it's bread and butter for Fox. If you don't, now you do.
Nails the lasers right into the forward air.
Into the forward air. Fox can actually combo to death off the forward air. He can go straight from the forward air to up smash in that situation.
Kiro again, choosing the taunt.
That's it.
Right into the up smash.
What'd I just say?
Jimmy Joe predicting the future.
Or Sensei's taking tips from this guy.
got one ear on the commentator.
Nice down tilt to pop him in the air. Time for a juggle. Beautiful lasers.
It's an easy 12 damage. He racks up.
Misses with the drill and follows him with a jab into the shine. Could have been bad for Fox there. Good DI. It's not going to be enough.
Fortuitous hit. Just wants to make sure. Is this a better matchup? Or
I'd say this is a better matchup for Pika than Falcon on Dreamland.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, look at... Wow. I can't believe he got back.
So they practically go even then.
Pika and Fox?
On this?
No, Pika definitely has the main advantage.
Bigger than stage.
Yeah. I mean, Hyrule...
Fox can just chill.
Has a little more space to work. But on this stage, you're too frequently finding yourself off the edge. And if you notice, when Pikachu's off the edge, he can get back. Fox,
anywhere. To the middle of the stage.
Fox has a really tough time recovering versus Pikachu once he's on the stage. You see that? I mean, there it is, right there. So you really have to be very, very technical, and you really can't. You have to be on your S game. Fucking your A game. You have to be on your S game with Fox, you know, on Dreamland against a good Pikachu.
Chains into it.
Which we know Sensei is, so, I mean, by no means.
By no means a push.
You know, you're not going to win these matches, but he might not win this one right here. Quick.
Takes one. It's one.
So it's 1-1 now. Sensei gets the counter pick.
The stage first. Or the counter.
Kiro's gonna go back to Captain.
Ooh, Falcon ditto.
Sensei's gonna play his third character.
His tertiary?
Well, I don't know if it's his third best, but it's his third different character he's played in the tournament. We've seen Fox, Pika, now Captain Falcon.
Quick kill. Luckily, the Falcon Ditto's on Dreamland last about 3.5 seconds. Short hop up there is just deadly. There's like, what, 15 of them in a row?
He does the taunt cancel with the wind. Into the Falcon kick!
Into
Sensei playing really tricky right now.
Can't land the spike. Forward air. Up air. Short hop revert.
That was a tipper of the up air. Uses the reverse up here to finish him.
If that's the reverse, then what's the horizontal descending? Double reverse.
Reverse is horizontal. They're behind
us. So it's just
tip. Very tip of the feet.
And instead of going straight, he went the way that the attacker was facing. And that will probably do it.
And Kira takes a stock lead here. Really interesting.
And Kiro goes once.
Kiro gives him the tie right now, so. They're at one game of peace. Lance is there. That'll be a stop. This Falcon Ditto skull will go just like that.
Three hits. Two. Three. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. And dead. Oh! He went for Flash. And he pays.
I mean, and this match is not over by any means. Mm-hmm. Sensei can get a grab. Or an up smash.
Very comfortable. Oh! Both blades.
That'll do it. Chased him. That was his only option in that situation to get him. And it works.
He won suicide. Threw him.
Fast fall that. I mean, if Kiro's percentage wasn't high enough, he might have died first. Sensei might have died first if Kira's percentage wasn't high enough.
Falcon drops like a bag of bricks.
Like a bag of bricks.
And we go.
Kira's gonna counter with to Dreamland. He's gonna go Pika again, and Sensei's gonna try his one more time with that Fox. He really wants to get this win.
Nice, he's able to get on top of him.
So we can drill him, it doesn't get...
Fox has a very short drill, I've noticed.
Oh, that's a beautiful...
Nice.
Beautiful, reflector. Kira with the up tail, that iron tail.
As screensaver mode activates.
Fox with a nice DI.
Tries for the display.
Gets back.
Wow.
Starts the combo.
Beautiful. It.
Oh, wow.
And he could have missed up smash, but he goes for a little bit of flare there. You got to see some real skill right there. He really wants this game with Fox.
Pikachu is not impossible to get shine, correct? I mean, because it's set not back.
No, Pikachu can definitely be given shine.
To the extent that, say, Falcon or DK.
Well, Pikachu by no means further than Falcon. I mean, he's set.
I thought it was
set knockback. Set knockback for each character, right? So Pikachu will always go the same distance every time he is reflector. And DK will always go the same distance every time a DK is reflector. DK will not go as far as Pikachu will. So moves with set knockback have set knockback for
each character,
depending on what character's hit with.
I was unaware of that. I thought all characters went.
I could be wrong on with certain exceptions, but.
Kira throws one.
Alright, so back at the match at hand, yeah. Let's get down stock here. Chasing almost the gimp with shine.
Single hit up air. Very strange. Got him out of it. Stroll over.
He was on the edge left. Of that jab's hitbox. It's pretty much even here. But as you know, the stock can be taken very quickly. That's part of the beauty of this game. Oh, he goes for the down smash. Pikachu's roll and just turn right on time.
Gets it.
Oh. The opts to not go with the forward smash.
Safer. Sensei's DI is very on point. And he recovered a hell of a
standing laser. I'm sure he didn't mean to do that.
Goes for it again, and
Sensei gimps him.
In the shine.
There you go.
Eating my words.
Could be down to Kira's last knock if he can't pull off another,
He misses the grab.
It's a dangerous spot.
A peek of back throw from anywhere on this stage is just... devastating.
Yeah. He manages to DI behind him. Oof!
He grabs the ledge. There's the back.
Wow.
Sensei's hitting him, recovers high. Misses the neutral air.
Sensei's just gonna get back on the stage after that. He's gonna try it again.
Recover high again.
Recovers low and manages to
make
contact.
Back, though. And he 2-2.
Tight game.
This game's winner is Pikachu.
Wow. Sensei's gonna take him to Hyrule.
Grand final. Grand final, last match on the castle. And
Sensei is gonna stick with Fox. He's sticking to his guns here. Very
really,
commendable.
He wants the Fox to go.
But now he has a little more ground to play with here, so it won't be as easily gimped on the stage. Let's see how he holds up versus Mika. This is a really fun match, I think. It's a challenging and fun match for Fox. You get a chance to play with
him. And much more diverse combos for both players. That 10 is...
Kero continues to DI really nicely.
Goes for the break, misses.
Manages to recover.
Yep.
See, and Kira Fox was low enough that he was able to DI and keep his stock. He got himself a second chance, and Kira blew it again.
If Kira didn't forward smash there, I don't think Fox would have been high enough.
You think the forward smash actually saves him?
I think it had that hitbox a little bit below, because Fox doesn't have a sweet spot that low, does he? He does?
You know what, I'm not really sure.
Because I know there are times when you like you just face plant right into the stage and...
Yeah. Really sure what Fox's sweet spot is. Just like we were talking about, I mean, some characters can sneak under that Pikachu's forward smash and still catch the ledge, like Samus. Because their sweet spot reaches to the above their boxes.
And he's got him in here.
Kiro with a nice little top.
Lowers his grab. Sensei's turn. Fox also very good down there.
Oh yeah, Sensei didn't even have to use the, he didn't even have to jump on the main part of the stage. He was able to forward throw him off the wall, hit the tent, just nice little off-stage, simple and effective.
Is Fox able to slant jump onto the main?
Absolutely, yeah. Fox's bread and butters in the tent is kind of like a back throw off of, back throw into the wall. And then after they bounce off the tent, a neutral air back into the tent where you land on the main part of the stage, and they land right in your wheelhouse for the up smash.
I know Pikachu needs to jump straight up and then adjust himself.
Yeah, pretty much most characters have some form of a combo like that. Yeah, you'll probably see this match from...
Just like that. Oh, he botches it.
Misses the up smash.
And that back air covers so much ground.
Sensei much more comfortable on Hyrule against Pika with Fox.
Yeah.
As you can see with this handy lead right now.
Covers high.
Tricky recovery to catch the ledge. Really good with that.
Hits him with the drill into the shines. And he's
just starting
to
see this here.
And he escapes. Machine gunning at this point.
Yeah, he eyes off the side of the tent. That'll be a star. This is probably an end here. I don't know how much Sensei wanted to work the stock.
Yeah. He really wants that GP.
I don't know if he wants to, if he cares about the stock lead, but I know he just wouldn't want to blow the match.
Yeah, he's got three losses with Fox holding over his head right now, and he loves using the taunt.
Waiting out the tornado, taunting. Sensei taunts on each ledge.
A useful little skill. Oh, that'll...
Sensei opts to chase him with an up air and finish it. Good games, guys.